welcome back from that short break here on the Tony and Tim Show. Of course, we had the weekend kicking things off on Saturday afternoon with the top six sides.
Yeah.
Of course, that we always mention. Chelsea took on Newcastle and had a narrow victory, 1-0 to nil. Of course, that goal coming from Marcos Alonso.
Yeah, Marcos Alonso giving Chelsea the 3 points, Tony. It was a game that Newcastle had been set up, drilled well, and I thought they didn't come negative for the first time. They were trying to attack Chelsea, look for something. They were unable to get a goal. But when you look at the way Newcastle is playing now, Tony, I think that the decent side. I think the United result gave them a boost. But Chelsea also learned, Tony, to win. Even if you don't play well, you're able to win, and Chelsea is doing that. Frank Lampard must be happy with the 3 points.
Of course, it was another 3 points at home for manager Frank Lampard, whose Chelsea side have suddenly come, of course, from their shell, finally, in as the season progresses. They will be very, very interesting to watch as the season progresses. This side, they now find themselves in the top four spots, of course, after the results around them favored them a little bit. Manager Frank Lampard will be happy with the Champions League place at the end of the season if that ban is upheld, even through January. So there, it was a big, big 3 points for Chelsea there. And, of course, at the same time, we had Tottenham, the other strugglers in the league. Picking up a point against Watford in a game they did deserve a point.
They didn't deserve, Tony. Picked up a debatable goal. The VAR showing no goal, and then the referee giving it. It was a mistake.
It was a
mishap there, yeah. But I think it should have stood. But Watford deserved to have gone 2-0. I thought De La Foe deserved the penalty there in that foul.
Big talking but point in that game.
A goal from Doucouré was not enough for them, Tony, to take the 3 points. And Kike Sanchez-Flores must be saying his team is undone, and he will be lodging an appeal to favour him maybe, because all decisions seem to be going
against Watford.
And this is how you get relegated, and you look at these small decisions to cost you a place in the Premier League.
No, but Tottenham Hotspur, on the other hand, need to check themselves.
This side
is in playing in the Champions League this season. They have a lot of games at home.
They have no injuries.
Thin squad, though. Yeah. Mm. If you to look around with the people that they let go and they didn't bring anyone in, they have players who know that the club doesn't need them around. So it will be very interesting to see what Pochettino has to do to this side to wake them up from their slumber. They are still struggling. We thought that this game against a bottom place side like Watford should have given them, the platform to excel, which wasn't to be. And of course, like you said, Kike Sanchez-Flores will be unhappy with that. It's almost the second game in running that they have a decision against them that could have given them all 3 points. They're still winless on 4 points, rocked at the bottom of the Premier League, this Watford side. Of course, Saturday evening, we had Manchester City travelling to London, a place that we know they love to visit. They beat Crystal Palace 2-0.
Beating them 2-0, Tony. Goals from Jesus, and then David Silva getting the second
nice
one there.
Nice flick from Sterling.
Perfect. All right. And the control he had to watch that ball all the way and connect it, I think that's a lot of talent and takes a lot of precision to do that. But you look at Man City, Tony, they played only two recognized fullbacks there as their defenders. The other makeshift defenders were their midfielders.
Otamendi and Rodri.
Yeah, it shows you how good this Man City side are. They're able to get results even with a deflated squad. But on the other hand, I thought the coach of Crystal Palace, Roy Hodgson, didn't do a good job. He just went negative in the game, and he tried coming out in second half, but it was too late for his team. So Man City, as you said, results favoring them now. They have 6 points to catch Liverpool, and I think that's a narrow gap now. It is open things up here.
Very, very big performance, of course, from Manchester City. Crystal Palace didn't really test their backline enough. There were big saves from Ederson
late in the game.
Of course, when they tried to come out, this Everton side and this Crystal Palace side to attack Manchester City. They are big points, 3 points for Manchester City. They keep marching on behind Liverpool, who we know cannot afford any slip-ups. Last season it was 7 points, and they matched that tally until the end of the season and won. Liverpool cannot afford any kind of slip-ups.
No more.
At least until they meet Man City.
No, they can't afford, because Tony, 6 points and Liverpool playing Tottenham next, Man City must be looking around the corner saying, should they drop points again here? We pounce on them. So Liverpool must keep winning.
Big one there for Pep Guardiola. And of course, on Monday night is when we saw the worst performance from Arsenal, from an Arsenal team traveling away to Bramall Lane against Sheffield, a newly promoted side. Arsenal losing 1-0,
Tony. I personally thought it was going to be a hard game. I did predict 1-1 for this game, but the performance that we saw from Arsenal was poorer than I expected. I do not understand, Tony, why is Ozil still frozen out of this team? There is no creativity there. We've spoken off air that maybe we need to see Ceballos playing ahead of Willock. Saka, why are these guys in Arsenal starting 11? I don't know for sure. And a lot of questions are going to be posed on Unai Emery.
It will be very interesting to see how the Arsenal fans take that loss, of course, with the game coming up in the Europa League in the midweek. Big performance from some of the lads in the Sheffield United side.
Yeah.
They held their own against a team like Arsenal that they might have expected to get more pressure. But they have a very interesting formation that they play this Sheffield side. Chris Wilder, their boss, has set them up to look defensive, but then they're attacking you.
Tony, it's a weird formation because I was surprised. Their centre-backs, they're the ones who attack. And
the centre-backs are in the top attacking midfield.
They're in attacking midfield, and they can't even be in the other box as a centre-forward. So it's a formation I think that Premier League teams still have to adopt. But it's also a formation, Tony, that if you get caught up, you can easily concede. And I thought if Arsenal had a creative player like maybe Ozil, they would have got those pockets of spaces and fed Aubameyang to get a goal, because we all know Aubameyang is starving. There are no attempts on him, and it's not helping that Pepe is not coming in with any goals.
Very, very interesting that you mentioned Pepe. He missed the chance of the game for me.
Yeah, glorious chance.
Glorious chance to tap it at the game still 0-0. He should have buried that chance. Nicolas Pepe is still struggling to adapt to the Premier League. He's failing to get the statistics that we all know he can put up that he did at Lille last season there. Of course, Arsenal getting nothing from that game, and of course falling down from third place that we started the weekend with, and now finding themselves in fifth place. This Arsenal side, many questions to be asked to Unai Emery as to why the players are playing as they are playing, which players are supposed to be starting. There, of course, he might have had one eye on the Europa League, but it's still far away. You can always play your best side. Of course, Arsenal fans will be excited that Lacazette is back in the side. But of course, the manager has to find a way of accommodating both him and Aubameyang to get the best out of the front three, like we were thinking at the beginning of the season. There are big games across the weekend. Of course, the table will be looking like how you see it on your screen right now. But of course, we have more football coming up in midweek. The Champions League returns.
Yeah, Tony, the Champions League returns, and fascinating fixtures are underway, because we know Real Madrid, Tony, are struggling in their group.
And domestically also.
Yeah, domestically too. They lost the game and they are away to Galatasaray tonight. I think that's going to be a tricky fixture for them. We also have Tottenham hosting Zvezda there. I don't know whether Tottenham have picked up their sleeves to get this. Tomorrow there's another big game between Inter and Dortmund.
That's
and
a
few couple of games there. Liverpool visiting Genk there. So it's going to be tricky all over. And then we have Europa on Thursday night. So it's going to be a lot of football this week.
Very, very football-filled week here on the Tony and Tim Show. Of course, don't forget to follow our pages, the Tony and Tim Show on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and of course our YouTube channel, the Tony and Tim Show as well. Click subscribe to never miss any of our videos, and of course follow the rest of the pages to never miss any of the information we share with you. With that, we have nothing left to say. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.